It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. This project scenario is based on the TerramEarth case study. Which of TerramEarth's legacy enterprise processes will experience significant change as a result of increased Google Cloud Platform adoption? We're given a list of items and we need to figure out which of these items is going to cause a significant change in the new process after adopting Google Cloud Platform as opposed to the legacy enterprise processes. The way we'll approach this is to list out each of the items and then figure out if there's been or if there's expected to be a change from the legacy process. First one, OpEx and CapEx. What are these things? CapEx is capital expenditure. The amount or the expenditure that you have to do when starting out the business for usually large ticket items. For example, setting up a data center, buying a large number of machines, doing all the networking. These are things that need to be done right at the start to even get the basic business moving. So the cost of this is going to be quite high, but its payoff is going to be over a long period of time. OpEx, on the other hand, is operational expenditure. The cost of running the business on a daily basis. With traditional systems, we are going to have a large CapEx because we need to plan for buildings and networking and machines. Whereas on the cloud, somebody else is doing that for us. So as a company, we don't need to bother as much about CapEx, especially when it compares to just the technical deployments. OpEx, on the other hand, is expected to increase because unlike the CapEx, which you've bought once and then you can use it to the hilt, OpEx is going to increase based on usage. So the cloud is pay-per-use. Therefore, the more you use, your operational expenditure is going to increase. And if you use less, it is going to reduce from that. But overall, the operational expenditure for cloud use is going to be higher than what it would be for legacy enterprises. So is there a change? My answer is a strong yes for this. LAN change management. We won't have to deal with LAN changes on the cloud. Somebody else is going to take care of that for us. In this case, Google Cloud. So this task is now entirely eliminated or is way less. We still need to find out and understand how the VPC works, how the virtual private cloud works, and we need to plan for it. But overall, LAN changes is not going to be our headache. So is there going to be a significant change because of that? My answer is yes. There's going to be a huge drop. How about capacity planning? Capacity planning is required so that we can acquire the resources that will meet peak demand. On the cloud, we don't have to necessarily plan for peak capacity or resources because it can scale as required. So our capacity planning requirements are going to drop significantly because the provisioning can happen automatically based on increase in requests and in load. Is capacity planning completely eliminated? The answer would be no. We still need to have a fair amount of planning for this, so that we can budget for how much we are going to spend. So for things like that, use the Google Cloud pricing calculator and we can estimate the budget that we need to set aside for adopting whatever solutions we choose within Google Cloud. Overall, is there a change in capacity planning? My answer is yes. How about TCO calculations? Our total cost of ownership involves other things like OpEx, CapEx, land management, the people who are going to be working on the project, allocation of some of the resources. So there is still going to be TCO calculations that need to be done. The line items might vary a bit, the value of those line items might change, but I think the process of doing TCO calculations is still going to be there. So I could argue that there is not much of a change there, but there's going to be some change. So it might not be a strong change, but there's at least some weak change. Maybe later in comparison to the other points, we can eliminate one of these. How about utilization measurement? Now, utilization and capacity planning are kind of related according to me. If there is going to be a lot of utilization, we need to plan for capacity accordingly. But in the case of cloud, we don't need to plan as much for capacity in advance. We can scale as is required. So utilization measurement is not going to have a big impact. However, we still need to plan for it to an extent. But that information is also given to us to quite an extent by Google Cloud using the logs, using stack driver monitoring. We are able to get instrumentation and information about how our resources are being utilized. So is our task of utilization measurement reduced? I would say the answer is yes. It is automatically provided or it is available to us via solutions like Stackdriver, and we don't need to do as much. Moreover, our utilization will directly impact the resource allocation because we could use load balancers and automatic scaling to achieve this. Therefore, I don't believe there's going to be as much a need to spend time on utilization measurement as we did on legacy systems. So therefore, is there a change? My answer is again, yes. How about data center expansion? I think this is a clear yes. We won't need to be managing data centers anymore. We have passed on the burden of that to Google Cloud in this case, and we can drastically or completely eliminate those tasks. Therefore, there's a significant change in data center expansion too. Given all these conclusions that I have drawn based on my arguments, let's go see which option we can choose now. The only thing we have been able to kind of eliminate is any option with TCO calculations, which is option B and D. The others are, well, it's arguable that there is going to be a significant change in all three of options A and C. What we're going to do now is go back to these line items and see if we can argue it harder or figure out if there is a particular part of the question that is being asked. What do they mean when they say there's a significant change? Are they asking for any change or are they asking for a significant drop alone? If it's an increase, maybe that's not something they're interested in, but they only want to see if there's a drop. It's obviously not clear from the question because it just says, is there a significant change? But given that we are not able to eliminate the remaining options, we are going to have to reconsider this question. Let's start with the bottom in this case. Data center expansion, the answer is there a huge change? The answer is yes. But it's a significant drop and not an increase. So based on our new argument that they're looking for only things where costs have increased, I would say the answer is no. There is a change, but it's not an increase. On a similar note, we can also say no to land change management because there's significant drop. We won't have to bother about land change management anymore. So land change management and data center expansion are very similar, and therefore both have to be no. If anyone is no, the other one has to be no. Similarly, for capacity planning and utilization measurement, is there a change? My argument originally was, yes, there is a change, but both of these are a significant drop. It is not an increase. So if you're taking the approach that the question maybe means a significant increase of change, we are going to have to eliminate both capacity planning and utilization measurement. Now going back to the options, what do we have? We have absolutely none. At least one of them eliminates all of the different answer options that we have. This question has been one of the toughest that I've seen on the practice exams. The problem with this question has been that because it is a little soft argument, you can probably argue it whichever way you want. You could probably answer it another way and come up with a completely different answer, and I could come up with something else. Maybe the person who planned this question or wrote this question had something completely different in mind. But I'm very interested to know what was the answer that you came up with when you went through this question yourself. For me, even though I finally found out the right answer looking at the Google practice exam, I still have been unable to figure out what should be the right answer in this case. So even after knowing the correct final answer, I am not able to come up with arguments that validate or corroborate that. Yet, let's try out what's the next step. Now, for me, something like data center expansion is a clear indication that there is a change, but it is a positive change. So I'm just going to eliminate data center expansion just because I'm in this weird situation now where I've got nowhere to go. I'm having to clutch at straws and say, okay, maybe data center expansion is a clear out, and therefore anything with that, I'm going to eliminate. So for me, C and D is out, and probably it's going to be one of A and B. What do we have in A and B now? Having eliminated data center expansion in both, let's look at what we have as strong positives in the other two. Now, OpEx CapEx is there in both, and we already said it was a strong yes for a change. There is an increase in OpEx and a decrease in CapEx, but it works under the circumstances. Capacity planning, it didn't work for us really, but both of them have capacity planning. So we are going to assume, okay, both of these are fine. Whoever thought of this question, maybe they saw a huge difference in capacity planning, and that's fair. So we are left with the remaining two now, land change management and TCO calculations. For me, land change management, there is a huge change. We don't have to do that at all. Similar to the idea of data center expansion, this is not our concern. TCO calculations, my argument was that, yes, there are some changes, but the line items are going to be similar with difference in the values. So my vote is for land change management, that it changes significantly, and TCO calculations, not so much. So I'm going to go for option A with the arguments that I've placed in front of you, and hopefully you have come up with some answer yourself too. However, the right answer according to the practice exam is option B. Capacity planning, TCO calculations, and OPEX CAPEX allocation is apparently the significant change as a result of increased GCP adoption compared to legacy enterprise processes. Like I said, even after knowing the answer, I cannot come up with arguments that corroborate that or that support this. So honestly, I don't know how to deal with this particular question. And hopefully, you know, we won't get questions like this in the exam. But if you've got a different argument to it that you think is better and supports option B, I would like to hear it. Again, wishing you the best on the exam and hoping you won't get a vague question like this without a clear question and without possibly clear options or options that you can argue for and against equally is something that I do not wish on you. If you thought that content was great, you absolutely must check out all our new upcoming content. So subscribe right away.